In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to create this unique presentation style in Revit. Well, not just how to create one style, actually just the whole approach, and then you can create multiple different styles by using this method. Let's go. Now, before we get into the video, if you don't want to do all of these steps yourself, you can actually get a free view template for Revit, which I have made available on my website. So on balkanarchitect.com, I'm going to include a link to that up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. You can download a set of 4 different view templates where you can just apply this view apply the set of view settings to any view, and you can instantly get this result, which I think is really cool. And also, while you're on the website, makes sense to explore some of the courses. I've got over 140 hours of content dedicated to Revit, so check it out if you're interested. So anyways, without any further ado, let's jump straight into, well, Google for beginning. So to create a really cool presentation like this, you need a really good color palette. And for that, I like to use the Adobe Color. So here, if I open up Adobe Color, it's going to look like this. You can kind of create your own if you want, or I like to go here to explore. You can use some keywords. Here you can see this is what's on offer. Now, once you find a color palette that works for your design, for example, let's say I want to use this one, you can actually download that as a JPEG, but for that you do have to sign into Adobe. Kind of an alternative option would be to either find a color palette here or anywhere else on the internet, and then just use a simple snipping tool. So snipping tool is something we all have on our computer. Go to new, and then just create like a snip, like this, and then we can just save that. So I'm just going to save this on my desktop. So let's call this one color. Okay, and then you can go to the color picker. So again, here I just Googled color picker, and we have this website which allows us to bring in an image. So go here to use your image, and then you can just upload an image from your computer. So if I upload this one, it's just going to upload that image. And now, as you can see, wherever I go, it's going to figure out the color and it's going to give me what's most important, which is the RGB values. So with the RGB values, you can then use that to build colors inside of Revit. Now I have kind of written down the colors and the color palette that I want to use for this project. So I'm not going to be using this, but this is basically how you can get to those colors here. You can find all of the values. Okay, so and you can go here to show more. So it's going to give you just a little bit more information on that, just if you're interested. So anyways, I'm just going to stop with this, and now let's go into Revit and let's get started with creating our cool presentation. So here I have this 3D view. I've used a section box to cut through the building so we can have this cut part, and then the rest is just like a regular 3D view. So the first thing that I like to do is get rid of any annotation elements. So for that, you want to go to Visibility Graphics, Overrides, VG is the shortcut, and here go to Annotation Categories, and then just I'm just going to uncheck all of them, and it's going to look like this. Now, if you perhaps have to adjust your section box, you can always go down here to Reveal Hidden Elements, and then you can select it and make any adjustments if necessary. I'm just going to escape out of that. Okay, so now to apply our whole kind of visual style, we're going to be doing that here in the Visibility Graphics Overrides. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go here and select everything. And then let's say I want to change the projection lines. So go here to Override, and then let's change the color here in the color. Now for the colors, I like to build out my custom palette here. So these are your custom colors. You can actually customize this in Revit, and I like to build that out before I get started so I can just easily apply colors. So I'm going to click in this empty field, and then I'm just going to add values for my first color, which I've saved from that website, and that's going to be 64. Now hit the tab key to toggle to the next one, 72, and then finally 96. So this is my new color. So I'm just going to click on add, and it's just going to place it there because this field is selected, and now we have that color saved. And now I'm just going to be adding the rest of the colors. I'm going to speed it up so you don't have to go through that repetitive process. And these are the colors that I'm going to use. So I like this dark desaturated blue palette with orange accents. So that's what we're going to be using. And first for the projection lines, I just want to use this first color. So click OK, OK again, and now that's applied. Then let's go here to patterns. So you have to click in one of the fields that is clickable. So here, for example, this one isn't, however, this one is. And then for the foreground, let's set this to solid fill and let's switch this to the secondary color. Click OK. Now moving to cut lines, let's change that. So color override, these are going to be the cut lines. And then the cut patterns are going to be this brighter orange. And then let's give it a solid fill as well. And this is it for now. So let's now hit apply. Okay, and then this is what that looks like. Now here, I don't like the fact that my topography is, well, like this, especially this orange. I think it's overwhelming a little bit, so let's change that. So go back to Visibility Graphics Overrides, find your topography. So here that's topography, and then I'm going to change the projection surface color to this, and then the cut color or cut pattern to this darker color. Oops, okay, apply, okay. And now it's going to look like this, which I think it looks a lot nicer. Okay, so now moving forward, we have to turn off this setting to some of the categories because I don't want to have exactly this effect applied to all categories. So for example, for floors, I want to change that. So what I'll do is, again, Visibility Graphics Overrides, find floors, and then for floors, I'm going to expand the whole menu and then select all of these. So what I'll do is for the projection surface, instead of having this color or this pattern, I'm just going to switch this to some concrete. Let's see, do we have some concrete pattern? Yeah, that will work. Click OK, apply. Okay, and now the floors are lighter, so I think the whole thing looks a little bit better. Now, moving forward, I would like to change some of the elements like the chairs and the furniture, specialty equipment, and so on and so forth. Now, with the floors, remember how we had to expand that menu like this and then select everything? Well, I would have to repeat that for multiple categories, which would just take too much time. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to utilize filters. So I'm just going to go here to view. Then I'm going to find filters and let's create a filter. So I'm just going to create a new filter. Let's call it the Balkan Architect Interior. Click OK. And then here we want to select all of the categories which we want to be kind of affected by this filter. So I'm just going to go here and select casework. I want definitely furniture. So let's find furniture. We can use furniture systems as well. We can go with specialty equipment. So let's find that. And then also generic elements would work as well, or generic models. Okay, so once we have created this filter, so that's going to use all of this, let's hit apply. Okay, so once we have this filter, we can go to Visibility Graphics Overrides, go to Filters, add a filter, and then let's add that Balkan Architect Interior filter. And then here we can add some overrides. So for example, here for the projection patterns, I can just go and I can say, okay, I want this to be gray, and I want this to be some, I don't know, like a gypsum plaster pattern. Okay, so now as you can see how the furniture here is now kind of white with that pattern. Okay, so it looks a lot better and a lot cleaner now with this approach. And you can just kind of continue playing around. You can make some overrides. I think overall this looks really, really well. So finally, what I like to do for the background is I like to apply a gradient. So go here to Visual Styles, Graphic Display Options. Make sure to turn on smooth lines. Makes sense to turn on ambient shadows, just like that. There we go. We can go to lighting, set that up to, I like to use 30, 40, 50. I think that gives us the best kind of look. And then finally for background, See how here for background I can apply a gradient, and then for that gradient what I'll do is for the sky color I'm just going to go with this, so that will be 215, 227, and then 226. So that will be for the sky, and then I like to make the horizon and ground be the same color so we don't get like a sharp line in between those two. So here right now if I hit apply, see how we have that sharp line which indicates the horizon. So because of that I like to change this to the same color, so this will be 242 242. Okay, that, and then I'm just going to apply that same color to this, so like that. Click OK, apply. See how now it's a lot nicer when we have that kind of clean gradient without that line. So there we go. That's going to be the effect that we're using. Of course, you can continue playing around, perhaps change the panels a little bit or something like that. But overall, I think the effect is really good. And now, most importantly, to apply this effect to the rest of your views, what you can do is you can just create a new view template. So you go here to view, go to view templates, and then create a view template from current view. Click on that, name it, we'll call this one the Balkan Architect View Template, click OK, and now, okay, so here, it's now here in the View Templates, click OK. So now if I go and create a new 3D view, so let's go to wherever, ground level, and then create a camera view, looking at the building from this side, I can perhaps come in, let's see. I like to use this full navigation wheel, so let's just kind of come in towards the building a little bit, perhaps like that, and then let's also cut a section just to make it a bit more interesting. So a section box, okay, I'll get rid of this, like that, select that section box, and then have a cut like that, I don't know. So let's say I'm happy with this effect or this look. So now what they can do is it can just go here to view templates, apply a view template, pick out my view template, and then hit apply properties. Okay, so this is going to be what that looks like. So we can easily apply this to the rest of our views, and that's the power of view templates. And as I said, if you want to download all of these view templates, you can find that on my website, balkanarchitect.com. I made it free for download. So I'm just going to be including that link, as I said, up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.